1st, 1939, World War II officially began, driving the powers of the world into a frenzy against each other. The world was divided into the Allies and the Axis. Throughout the next 3 years of warfare and destruction, the development of new and more efficient weaponry was always of top concern. Weapons such as the M1 carbine, mortars, grenade launchers, and chemical weapons and biological weapons created an arms race between countries to develop powerful arms in order to inflict fear and pain upon its imposers.
In August 1939, the United States was under continual pressures by both the Allies and the Axis to enter World War II. On August 2nd of the same year, Einstein, being aware of the development of uranium-235 in Germany, issued a letter to President Franklin D. Roosevelt, warning of the possible development of nuclear weaponry in Germany.
In 1941, the United States declared war on Japan due to the attack on Pearl Harbor. Roosevelt said to Congress, "Since the unprovoked and dastardly attack, there is little else to do." Pressures mounted further as Germany grew closer to making the atomic bomb a reality. Franklin D. Roosevelt feared that Germany would beat the United States to the development of the bomb, and was inspired by the letter Einstein sent to create the Manhattan Project, which was first issued in 1942.
Under the control of Major General Leslie R. Groves, Jr., America's top scientists began working on the nuclear bomb. The experiments were conducted at Oak Ridge, Los Alamos, Argonne, and Hartford. Scientists such as Albert Einstein, David Bohm, Leo Szilard, Eugene Wigner, Otto Frisch, Rudolf Pierlos, Felix Bloch, Niels Bohr, Amelia Segre, James Frank, Enrico Fermi, Klaus Frosch, and Edward Teller worked on the atomic bomb.
In 1945, the first nuclear bombs were finished, tested, and deployed. On August 6, 1945, the B-29 Enola Gay flew over Japan carrying Little Boy. It was the first atomic bomb ever used as a weapon. At 8:15 a.m., Little Boy exploded above Hiroshima. Sixty-6,000 were instantly killed, while another 60,000 were fatally wounded.
On August 9th, just 3 days after the Hiroshima bombing, Fat Man was dropped on Nagasaki. The bomb exploded at 11:02 a.m. JST. The actions proved to become incredibly controversial, and they're still debated over today. Some of the American public despised the use of bombs, while others praised it and saved the lives of millions of American troops.
After witnessing the devastation the bombs brought upon Japan, a majority of the scientists involved in the Manhattan Project instantly changed their views. The scientists, who were mostly pro-nukes, were now completely against their use and development.
In Los Alamos, one of the locations for testing the nukes, the scientists witnessed the U.S. government trying to veil the weapons behind a wall of secrecy. The Manhattan Project was so secret that Congress did not know what it was funding, and Vice President Harry S. Truman did not learn about it until FDR's death made him president. In the situation of extreme secrecy, there was almost no ethical or political debate about the bomb before it was dropped on the two cities by a bureaucratic apparatus on autopilot.
The scientists who believed that these weapons' damage should be known to the world later congregated to create the Bulletin of Atomic Scientists. The original founder and editor of the Bulletin of the Atomic Scientists was biophysicist Eugene Rabinowitz. He founded the magazine alongside physicist Hyman Goldsmith. Rabinowitz was a professor of botany and biophysics at the University of Illinois and was also a founding member of the Continuing Committee for the Pugwash Conferences on Science and World Affairs. Other scientists that joined the Bulletin of Atomic Scientists include Max Born, Einstein, James Franck, Robert Oppenheimer, Leos Lazard, Edward Teller, and Harold C. Urey.
Being aware of the dangerous capabilities these weapons of mass destruction imposed upon the world, the scientists were not only the leading causes for the development of the atomic bomb, but also advocated against the use of the development of such weapons.
The magazine, which was published every 15 days, highlighted the advancement in the scientific community, with special emphasis placed on the growing threat of nuclear warfare. As a result of this, one of the most iconic symbols was born, the Doomsday Clock. The Doomsday Clock worked effectively in instilling fear in the hearts of fellow scientists who received the bulletin, causing many scientists to protest and abandon weapons of mass destruction.
However, the magazines also excelled in educating the non-scientific American public. The magazine used propaganda, facts, and other methods to alter the views of millions of Americans by explaining how nukes specifically would lead to the mass warfare, nuclear fallout, and destruction of all life on the world. The Bulletin of Atomic Scientists believed that the atom bombs would be only one of the many future weapons from Pandora's box of modern sciences.
In the early stages of the bulletin, the scientists focused on three main stages. These stages were failure, peril, and fear. The scientists increasingly rose awareness of the destruction the bombs could make, and often wrote about how the only way to prevent the abuse of the weapons was to destroy them. This was later led by a small movement to remove the nukes from the state's hands. They believed that the power to destroy the world should not rest in the hands of a minority of the population, but in the hands of the people who inhabit the Earth. The movement was particularly led by Oppenheimer, yet failed and was dubbed the Failure Period.
The Peril Period emphasized the growing threat of foreign countries creating their own nuclear weapons, and originated after Russia performed its own nuke test in 1949. Peril took an in-depth view of the true threat of the atomic bomb, stating various times that if the nuke becomes more popular in foreign countries, their use in warfare would be definite and uncontrollable. Harrison Brown dubbed the near future as the point of no return, meaning that if the threats of nuclear warfare continued to grow, it would be inevitable to return to a society in which it is possible to avoid nuclear warfare. There will be no returning because the world will have ended.
Fear was self-explanatory. This time period in the Bulletin's history revolved around scaring the audience of the magazine into believing that weapons of mass destruction must be stopped, and what weapons that exist must be destroyed. The Doomsday Clock was largely a part of the fear movement. It consisted of two hands shaped like bullets. When the two hands pointed to midnight, the end of the world was predicted. The further the hands were from 12, the further we were from blowing ourselves up. In 1947, the hands were 7 minutes from midnight. In 1953, when the Soviet Union was testing nukes, the hands were 2 minutes from midnight. In 1991, 17 minutes until midnight, and in 2010, the hands stood 6 minutes from midnight.
The Bulletin of Atomic Scientists was one of the most successful protests of weaponry, and while it led to no immediate responses, the bulletin rose the awareness necessary to persuade Americans that weapons of mass destruction were destroying the world and its inhabitants.
In 1955, many of the scientists who had major roles in the Bulletin of Atomic Scientists later went on to sign a document issued by Bertrand Russell. The document was called the Russell-Einstein Manifesto, which highlighted the notorious abuse, development, and harmful outcomes of nuclear weapons. The signatories of the document included Max Born, Percy W. Bridgman, Albert Einstein, Leopold Enfield, Frederick York Curie, Herman J. Muller, Linus Pauling, Cecil F. Powell, Joseph Rotblat, Bertrand Russell, and Hideki Yukawa. Max Born and Albert Einstein specifically played a large role in this document and in the Bulletin of Atomic Scientists. The success of the manifesto later led to the first Pugwash Conference.
Today, the Bulletin of Atomic Scientists is still very active. It has continuously released magazines and press updates from some of the world's brightest scientists regarding not only nuclear weapons, but climate change, nuclear energy, and biosecurity. The Bulletin remains one of the most influential organizations in the world, tackling an issue that has been confronting and threatening the world since the discovery of uranium-235.
Through brave endeavors by some of the brightest people in history, an active movement was established to combat a problem that otherwise would have gone out of control. Einstein, Russell, Fermi, Born, and Oppenheimer clearly led a somewhat failed yet important movement in American history by becoming the most anti-nuclear people in the world.
It is a shame that so many people had to lose their lives to the power of nuclear weapons in order to reel in such a small reaction. These scientists were aware of the serious threat these weapons held and opposed them long before those who had used them and long before those who had no idea of their use. After witnessing the tragic effects of the nuclear bomb, both firsthand in military tests and through its senseless use on the Japanese people of Nagasaki and Hiroshima, the ideology of the scientists switched. However interesting it may be, it is easy to understand how the use of such powerful weapons would cause those who worked on developing them to lead a scientific revolution in efforts to remove them from our planet. Because of the efforts of these scientists, the hand of the doomsday clock may drift ever further from midnight.
We knew the world would not be the same. Few people laughed. Few people cried. Most people were silent. I remembered the line from the Hindu scripture, the Bhagavad Gita. Vishnu is trying to persuade the prince that he should do his duty, and to impress him